Have you ever gone to a website and such as textures.com and saw all these great shaders and you have no idea how to implement them into Maya? This video tutorial is for you. Hey guys, it's Monica at Academic Phoenix Plus and welcome to a texturing tutorial. In today's tutorial, we're going to take all of these textures and implement it into Maya. If you're new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out your creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in texturing simple assets using these downloaded files. All right, so there is a variety of websites out there that provide you with shaders and textures. Now, the fun thing about this is that in textures.com, it has a ton of them. And as long as you create an account, you can get a few for free. So you should definitely check that out. Other websites include Polygon with two eyes and Polyhaven, which if you've seen my lighting tutorials, I have used their HDRIs, but they also provide shaders. What you want to do is find the one that you want to use. And you can see that we have a ton. Again, this is under textures.com and they have a ton. And I personally chose sci-fi because A, it's cool. So here's sci-fi for PBR materials. And B, it will also show me how to not only do all the regular maps, but also how to connect emissive maps, which is the glow maps. So you click on that. This is what it looks like. What you're going to see is that you can get the albedo, which is basically color diffuse, depending what software you have. You have a height map, which in Maya will mostly be for displacement, which we're going to cover later in another tutorial. Right now, I just want to focus on the fundamentals. So I'm going to download the albedo. I'm going to download the normal map, the roughness map, as well as the metallic map, and of course, the emissive map. Now, the ambient occlusion can be used with the multiply node in albedo, but again, it's a little bit more advanced. So I'm just going to go over the basics. That being said, I already downloaded them. So let's go ahead and jump into Maya. And we have this really simple scene. I'll scale this up a little bigger so you guys can check it out. And then I also have this dome. If you want to follow along, you just have to go to Arnold Light, Physical Sky, and you will get this dome. This is what we currently have. Nothing major. Go ahead and take a snapshot by clicking on this little camera below. First, we're going to select our two objects, right click, assign a new material. And we're using Arnold because I'm using an Arnold shader. And I'm going to go into AI standard surface shader. I like to label things. So let's go to sci-fi, shader. And the first one we want to do is base color. So let's click on this little guy right here, which is a connection. We're going to go to file, which is the fourth one down. And then there's a little folder. Click on the little folder. And if you have your project set, you should automatically be able to see your source images. So I am going to go to my sci-fi textures and grab the albedo. If you don't see anything, don't worry. Just press the number 6 on your keyboard, and now you have the color map. So I'm going to take a render so you guys can see the impact that it had. Press play. So far, so good. All right, take a snapshot. Press stop. So next in the shader, we have metalness. What we're going to do is the same thing. We're going to click on this little checker. We're going to go to file. We're going to go to the folder, and we're looking for metalness. So here's metallic. There you go. Click open. And then I'm going to show you something that's very interesting about Arnold and how to fix it. So when I render, you're going to notice that it looks like metalness has completely taken over. And the reason why is because you have to do a couple of steps to be able to get metalness to look correctly. So what you need to do is in the file, you're going to, instead of using this color space, which is sRGB, you're going to go to utility and choose raw. You're also going to scroll down to color balance and turn on alpha is luminance. And now we'll see the effect. And there we go. You can see that the metal is now is very metallic and very shiny, and the other areas are not, which is exactly what we want. So I'm going to go ahead and let that render and then take a snapshot. Here we go. Take a snapshot. So you can see the difference between this one and this one. Pretty dramatic. All right. Press stop. Moving on. Now you can just click on this or to go back to your shader, or you can click on this little button, which is basically going back up into the hierarchy. Click on that. Here's our color. Here's our metalness. And now we're going to go to specular roughness. Now, please don't get confused with diffuse roughness. That's something else. We're going to go to specular roughness. Click on this little connection. Go to file. Scroll up a little bit. Go to folder. And then again, we're going to go and grab the roughness. Dink. So this is going to be the same story as metalness, but let's take a look what it looks like right now without changing any attributes. right? As you can see, all of it disappeared. The roughness disappeared. It looks like just a diffuse. So let's go ahead and fix that. We're going to go back into our file, change our color space to raw, and then turn on alpha's luminance. And now we have roughness. Let it render for a second so then we can compare it. It's still very reflective, but if you compare it, you can see how much it's helped roughen up the edges. So you can see that there's scratches, there's some stains, things like that on the texture so that it looks a little bit more rough, especially when some areas need to be rough and other areas need to be shiny, not just the metal. So that really helps make this look a little bit more realistic and even. All right, let me take a screenshot of that, or a snapshot. Let's go back up. And now the fun one, which is the normal map. So we're going to scroll down to the bump mapping. We're going to click on this little icon again. We're going to go to file. It's going to start feeling familiar. But this time, when we click on file, we end up in what's called the bump 2D node. The bump 2D node tells Maya that this is actually going to fake height. So it's going to rise and fall. Now we are using is what's called a normal map. And a normal map looks like this, right? A rainbow of colors. Every single pixel has an RGB number, and that value is XYZ coordinates. It's pretty fancy. Previously, it used to be a bump map, which is a black and white image. So if you guys wanted to, you could potentially go to here and download the height map. But nowadays, height maps are used for displacement and normal maps are used for all the details. So that being said, to make sure that it reads it correctly, we're going to go to use as and change this to tangent space normal. That tells Maya that the file that we're going to attach is should be read as an RGB. Let's go to bump value and click on this connection, which takes us to the file. Scroll up a little bit and then click on the folder. And just like what we've done before, we're going to go to normal, open sesame, and then we're going to choose raw and just double check that alpha is luminance is on, which it is. And then let's hit play and see what that looks like. And now we're starting to get the details. Take a snapshot of that. Right, so you can see now that we're getting details in the metallicness, we're getting details, depth information in a variety of places, which gives us more realistic look. So that being said, I'm going to keep that playing. And then just so you can see how it reacts to light, I'm going to start rotating this slowly. Hopefully my computer can handle it. I'm going to move this light more towards this direction. And you can see how the highlight changes, how there is more. Now we can see a little bit more of that normal map. Looks really nice. And the shading's looking really nice. So let's review what we went over. We had this little guy right here with no information, the diffuse, metalness without raw and alpha's luminous on. Here it is. Then here comes the roughness and here comes the normal map. And that's how you get this beautiful looking map. Gonna press stop. Now we do have one more, which is emissive. Let's open up the sci-fi shader and you can see that we have an emission map here. So open that up and we got to turn it on first. So this is the weight. We're turning it on. Now it looks like it's going to glow, but it's everywhere. So we're going to choose a color map. Same story. We're going to click on this little checker, go to file, go to folder, and then we're going to find our emissive map. There it is. And you'll notice that it's just a black map with anything that's black is not going to glow and anything that has color is going to glow. So we're going to click on open and same story. Hopefully you guys are getting the idea. Make sure both of these are active. Alpha is luminance and raw. And render. There you go. And now we have an emissive map. So this is what the albedo map looks like, and it's a little lighter than what we have here. And that could be a variety of reasons. My light could be kind of dark, so I can take my dome and increase the intensity to a little bit brighter. Whoops, I just wanted to do 1.5. So now we have a little brighter scene. What you could also do, though, is go in and do the same thing for the color map. So we can always go to color, click on this little guy, and I sometimes hesitate to use this. I test it out to see, but you can see that when you change the raw, it becomes extremely bright. So, you know, take it with a grain of salt when you guys create this, because it can really brighten your texture. Let it render. I'm going to hit stop, take a snapshot so you can see the difference with, well, I increased the intensity of the light as well. If you find that to be a little too much, you can always go back to sRGB, and I'm going to show you how to use exposure. So color balance is at 0 for exposure. And if you want to just brighten your texture just a little bit, you can always increase the exposure. Right, so this is what we had before. This is what we had now. This is with raw. This is without the raw. And it's kind of fun to play with this because you can make some really fun changes with the color texture. So if you wanted to brighten it up again, increase the color gain, which, you know, things like that, you can play with these to get you some different results. And you can change the color, by the way, if you wanted to do that. You don't have to. It's just wanted to show you that you're not limited to just what's in the map. You can also alter things in your shader. And that is how you attach files from textures.com and other websites onto your Maya file. So enjoy this process because it's super fun. You get to just create your models, UV map it, and then texture it, or download models that are already UV mapped and use these textures to help you build your assets. One last thing, what I'm going to do is to render this really nice. I'm going to delete this, add myself a Arnold Light Sky Dome. I'm going to grab this color. I'm going to click on this and grab myself perhaps a cool looking. And by changing the HDR dome to a file, you can now see how much of an impact it makes on the texture. It looks significantly more realistic. So this one is, again, from Polyhaven. And I'm going to click on this little connection just to kind of show you guys a different version. Let me take a snapshot of that. Go to the folder and let's do like a evening one because those are always really pretty. This one is called Shanghai Bundle. And you can see that because of all the beautiful colors in the scene, it really brings out the sci-fi aspect of this particular scene. So there you go, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you learned a thing or two about how to attach textures to your shaders in Maya. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you found this video helpful and you want to see more. That is your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. And also take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. There you can find free downloads such as ebooks, 3D models, and so much more. So again, thank you so much for taking the time to watching this video. Keep creating, and I will see you next time.